Do you want to know where to start looking for land to buy? I'm going to give you 7 places. Hey, now these 7 places are not built on the basis of magic jelly beans. I mean, if you're expecting a super secret place that nobody's ever looked, this video is not going to work for you because that just doesn't exist. Now, I know there are people that'll tell you that, and there are probably videos on YouTube somewhere that are talking about the super secret place to buy super cheap land. That's not the reality. What I'm going to talk about is the foundation of where you begin looking to buy land that you either want to keep for yourself or that you want to eventually sell for profit. First place I'll tell you to begin is pretty obvious. You got to start on the internet. It's so easy nowadays to go online and Google land for sale in XYZ, wherever you're looking, wherever your geography is, or go to major websites that sell land, landflip.com, landwatch.com, landsofamerica.com, farmandranch.com, recland.net, my site, anywhere that sales specializes in rural real estate, go and start looking. Now, here's why. It's not so that you're going to just find the property that you can run out and buy. I'm asking you to go and start this search so that you start seeing what things are priced for, looking at how things are classified in terms of their highest and best use, and then how that use translates into the asking price. Now, the asking price and the selling price aren't the same thing. You and I both know that. However, you can start tracking that, getting an idea of what things are being marketed for in your area, and you can start developing that little mental database that's going to trigger, I promise you, at some point as you keep looking and you keep searching and gaining information. You're also going to start noticing some of the same properties as you do this search routinely. You're going to start seeing that this same property has been on the market for, well, it was on the market last time you looked. There's some tracts out there that have been on the market for quite a while. And so with those two things that you're doing, searching and starting to notice pricing and starting to get an idea of what's on the market and how long it's been on the market, you may very well stumble into a deal just by doing that. You may start noticing, hey, I've noticed all of these certain types of tracts have been an asking price in this ballpark, but here's one that they're asking a good bit lower. I wonder why. Maybe that's something to look into. Or you start noticing this track has been on the market for quite a while and it's really what you're looking for and it's where you're looking. That might be a property that's ripe for an offer. That's the kind of track sometimes sellers are ready to just make a deal and move on with their life. And the only way you can swerve into those deals is to spend time on the internet looking and studying. Hey, another thing you've got to do, you've got to reach out to any real estate agents that you know. Just a handful of people, and if you'll think you know somebody who's a real estate agent, or you have a friend who has a friend, you've got some connections to some real estate agents in your geography. And just call them up, tell them who you are, and generally what you're looking for. I'm a licensed real estate broker in 6 states. My phone rings off the hook every day. Emails flood in, people looking for property. Don't be the kind of person that bombards them with a huge amount of information. So tell them who you are. Tell them very specifically what you're looking for in 2 or 3 little small little chunks of information and make it realistic. Make it something that is in the realm of reality so they're not rolling their eyes on the other end of the phone. Give them a ballpark price that you're interested in. Tell them to reach out to you. Make sure you're ready to buy before you do that. And people don't want to waste their time with folks that aren't for real. Tell them what you're looking for. Be polite, be kind, be brief, and be serious. You might get a nibble on that. Not today, not tomorrow, but maybe down the road. If you're in the kind of business where you routinely are dealing with accountants and attorneys, be sure to let those folks know that you're in the market and generally what kind of property you're looking for and where. I've had deals that have come to me, an attorney who's calling me because a client that they're working with for any number of reasons has a property that they want to sell or need to sell. And I've made deals just like that because they knew that I was looking and they know the kind of properties that I want to buy. Hey, number 4, you gotta do it. Craigslist, online shoppers guides, and even any print publications that are still out there, the Penny Saver, the Thrifty Nickel, or any kind of classified ad, you gotta spend time routinely just going through it, because you'll swerve into some deals like that from time to time. People still advertise there. A lot of people don't spend the time looking there because we've got these devices. We're on our phone all the time. If it's not on the internet, we assume it doesn't exist. There's still people that use print ads. Pick one of those little things up at the convenience store or the hardware store, wherever you are, where you happen to have them. All over the country, those little papers and publications are still in existence. And of course, you've got the electronic classifieds as well. Spend some time routinely making sure you look those over so you don't miss an opportunity. Number five, be sure to let your friends know what you're doing. Now, I don't mean bug them to the point they're no longer your friends. Your friends have CPAs, attorney. Your friends have real estate agent friends. All you're doing is spreading your circle. Just let them know what you're doing casually, politely, and let them know to keep their eye out for you. And if they run into something or someone who's interested in selling property, just to let you know. Hey, the sixth place I'll tell you to look is just in your world when you're out driving around. For sale signs are everywhere, new ones, old ones. Just keep your eyes open looking for properties when you're out and about. Sometimes you just need to take a good old-fashioned Sunday drive. Some areas you haven't been in before, go down some roads you haven't been on in a long time. It'll help you understand the property in your area. But you also may run into some stuff for sale that's not on the market in traditional manners, meaning it's not on the MLS. Other real estate company doesn't have it. It's one of those properties that may have been in those classifieds that you missed, but now you see the sign, the for sale sign. It's just a numbers game. The more of those you see, the more you call and the more you talk to people, sooner or later, you're going to swerve into a deal. The reason people miss these opportunities is it's not sexy. It's not finding this great property online when you're searching in the comfort of your own home with a cup of coffee or a glass of wine. You swerve into a deal that is off the beaten path, that other people are overlooking. That's where you make deals. You find them where other people aren't looking. Hey, the last one I'll give you is the public records. Now, this one is tricky. It's a little advanced. You've got to have some knowledge and understand how to look. The more you start doing this, you're going to acquire that information. You're going to learn how to look up properties online, you know, through your county or parish tax districts, clerk's offices, tax assessors, where that data is available. It's not available everywhere, but it's available in most places. And you're going to start being able to identify properties. You'll be able to look up who the owner is. You maybe send out a letter. Typically, where you're going to find those deals in the public records, you're doing some research on a property that's already on your mind. I personally have bought a number of tracts where I was working on one property. I looked at all the adjoining landowners and sent out some letters to, hey, I'm buying this property. I'm interested in your property. It joins it. Would you be interested in selling it? Lo and behold, suddenly you got a deal. There's no magic pill for this. It's just good old work, networking, and hustling. Folks, if you'll do these things, you will swerve into some deals. You can buy them, make some money. Thanks for watching our videos. There's some more right there. Check them out.